Welcome students of class 11. Now today I will discuss on the thermodynamics fifth part. On the last day we have discussed on the what is extensive and intensive property and what is composite property, and today it is the next part, that is what is specific heat and the parameters, that is Cp and Cv. So this is known as molar heat capacities. So the specific heat and the heat capacity or molar heat capacity. So what is specific heat? The amount of heat required to increase the temperature by 1 K of 1 gram of liquid is known as its specific heat. What is specific heat? So the unit mass and the temperature increase, that is 1 K, is known as specific heat. And when the 1 gram is converted to 1 mole, then it becomes the molar heat capacity or simply the heat capacity. So heat capacity is the heat required for a change in temperature of 1 mole substance, 1 mole substance. So it is the heat capacity. Heat capacity may be of two types, that means heat capacity or heat required at constant pressure and at constant volume, Cp and Cv. Now Cp, that means change in temperature or change in heat content at constant pressure, and change in temperature or change in heat content at constant volume is known as Cv. Now specific heat is directly proportional to the substance, and there is an equation which comes from the that is Q equal to C M into delta T. It is also a rule of heat exchange. It is ruled as calorimetric rule. Calorimetric rule. That means when heat is exchanged, heat is evolved from one system and get absorbed from the another system, there is no loss in the heat content. There one system will loss of it and another will gain of it, and the system, the both the system is in equilibrium. It is known as calorimetric rules. Now Q equal to C into M into T, this comes also from the calorimetric. Now Q, that is heat absorbed or emit, C, that is the specific heat, M is the mass, and delta T is the change in temperature. Now using this equation, that is Q equal to C M into delta T, we should derive a relation between Cp and Cv. So the relation between Cp and Cv, relation between Cp and Cv. From the previous day we know that change in Qp is equal to delta H and Qv equal to delta U. Now if we put this equation here, so Qp equal to Cp into delta T and Qv equal to Cv into delta T, right? Now Qp is also delta H, so delta H is equal to Cp into delta T, and delta V, delta U equal to Cv into delta T or dT, del T. Using this by 1 by 2, so this is the two equation. Now next Cp minus Cv, so Cp is equal to Qp minus Qv. Now we have to make the derive del H equal to derive this equation, that is Cp minus Cv, we have to take help of the another one equation, that is del H equal to del U plus del N RT. Del H equal to del U plus del N RT. Now here del H, that is del U plus del N, here n equal to 1, so it becomes r into delta t as n equal to 1. That means if we are calculating for the molar heat capacity. So del H equal to del U plus del nRT. Now del H is equal to Cp dT or Cp delta T, and del U equal to Cv into delta T plus R into delta T. Now Cp minus Cv into delta T is equal to R into delta T. Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So it is R is equal to universal gas constant. So the relation between Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So there are equations needed, that is the heat absorbed by the system depends on the specific heat, mass content and change in temperature, and also the equation derived earlier, that is Qp, that is change in heat content at constant pressure and at constant volume, and the third one, that is del H equal to del U plus del nRT. So there are three equations are needed to derive the equation, that is Cp minus Cv equal to del H, Cp minus Cv equal to R. Now the measurement of del H and del U. So for here also the same equation, that is H equal to MST or heat change equal to specific heat into mass into change in temperature is required. This equation is also required, that is Q equal to C into M into delta T. It is required. Now here to derive delta H measurement. So to derive delta H, so delta H, we know that when a system emits heat, it is known as exothermic, and delta H equal to minus V, and when it absorbs heat, it is known as endothermic, where H is equal to plus V. Now to derive delta H, the instrument is required is coffee cup calorimeter. For this contain, it is a rough sketch. Here is the system, and system here is a thermometer, it is sealed thermometer, and there is the stirrer. This is thermometer, and this is the system, and the system contains water, and it is a bottle of polystyrene, that is insulator. It can confirm us that there is no heat is exchanged from the say surrounding to the outside world. Now here the system is burned, and the heat content, that is the emitted heat, is calculated by this equation, which is converted or uplift the system's temperature, that is the water temperature, which is detected in the thermometer. Now by this equation, that means change in temperature, that is delta T, and then Q, here the volume is constant, so it is the Qp is equal to Cp into M, that is 1 mole, and into delta T. By using this, that is Qp, that is equal to delta H, Cp dT equal to delta H. So by using this equation, we can measure the delta H. Now next equation, that is delta U measurement. Here the instrument required is equal to the bomb calorimeter. There is a bomb which is delta U measurement, that is there is a bomb that is called bomb calorimeter. It is also the same principle is used here also, that the heat evolved from the system is used for the increase in the temperature of the surrounding. So it is just like this. It is the bomb made of steel, and it is also sealed. Now the delta U measurement, that means here the work done by the system must be nil. So work done by the system must be nil, that means the volume, the volume is fixed. Volume is fixed. So we know that the pressure work is equal to P into D. So as D equal to 0, so work equal to 0. So delta U equal to change in heat content, that is QV. This is the equation. And also QV equal to CV into delta T. Now, as CV, that is specific heat capacity of the metals or the systems are known, then only the temperature we have to record. And the temperature is recorded by the thermometer. And as the increase in the temperature of the water body, here is the water, is taken and the surrounding, it is also called water bath. So here, the temperature is increased in the water bath is detected as delta T, and by this way we can calculate the QCV of the system. Next, that is Hess's law of constant heat summation. Hess's law tells that for a given chemical process, the net heat change, it may be QP or QV, will be the same whether the process occurs in one or in several steps. So here the heat energy which is evolved from the system is same in the overall process, or it may be a one-step reaction or a multi-step reaction. For example, Hess's law. It is also called Hess's law of constant heat summation. So, for example, C plus O2 equal to CO2. Here, the heat energy evolved will be QP is equal to minus 94.05 kilocalorie. Now, it may be that C plus half of O2, that is equal to CO. Here, QP is equal to 26 minus 42 kilocalorie. And CO plus half of O2, that is equal to CO2. Here, QP is equal to minus 67.63 kilocalorie. Now, if we summed up these two, it will be equal to that of the first one. So, from this, it is proved that the equation goes on one step or in multi-step reaction. In both the cases, the total heat change is same and it is given by the Hess. On the next day, we will define the different heat change process or different change, and also change in the internal energy, change in enthalpy, and the Born-Haber cycle. Thank you.